So hi students. So in the last video lecture we have studied with the terms like vapor pressure. So in today's lecture we will discuss very important topic, that is vapor pressure of solution containing two volatile components. So what is mean by vapor pressure? The pressure of the vapor above the surface of the liquid is called as vapor pressure, or at equilibrium the pressure of vapor above the surface of the liquid is called as vapor pressure. So in this topic we will discuss with the solution which consists of a two volatile component. We know that what is meant by volatile: a liquid which has tendency to undergo evaporation and formation of the vapor. So here the solution which consists of a two component, and both two component, one is a solvent and second is a solute, and both are volatile. Volatile liquid having a tendency to evaporate and form a vapor pressure. So here I have taken a solvent A1 and solute A2. A1 solvent will undergo evaporation and formation of the vapor pressure, which is P10, and having a mole fraction x1, and it has a partial vapor pressure, that is a P1. Okay, solid, that is A2, it undergo evaporation and formation of vapor pressure, that is P20, and has mole fraction x1 and partial vapor pressure, that is a P2. Okay, now when we mix together, when we add solid into the solvent, definitely there is a formation of the solution. So A1 plus A2, that is formation of the solution. Now solution will evaporate. During the evaporation, here A1 molecule also evaporate and A2 also evaporate. So vapor pressure of solution is the contribution of the A1 molecule as well as A2 molecule. Okay, now so we will not write here P10 plus P20, means vapor pressure of pure A1 and vapor pressure of pure A2, we will not consider here this. So in case of solution, while we writing the vapor pressure of solution, we consider as partial vapor pressure. We consider as partial vapor pressure, that is P1 and P2. Okay, so from here there is a generation of the Raoult's law. Very important, Raoult's law. Now what the Raoult's law states, that Raoult's law states that partial vapor pressure of each component is directly proportional to the mole fraction of that component in a solution. Once again, what the Raoult's law states, that partial vapor pressure of each component is directly proportional to the mole fraction of that component in our solution. Same here, if we write P2, so partial vapor pressure of P2 is directly proportional to the mole fraction of that component in our solution. Okay, so this is the Raoult's law. We can also define the Raoult's law in another way. We write as P1 is equal to P10 x1, which is given in your textbook. Here the partial vapor pressure of each component is the product of vapor pressure of pure component and its mole fraction. Another, P2 can be written as P20 x2. Okay, now come towards this side. What it says, that
partial pressure is directly proportional to the mole fraction. Means that mole fraction means jitna number of moles zyada hoge. This example here, A1, A2, A1, A2, A1, A2. Okay, these are molecules are present in the solution. Jitna A1 ke mole jitna zyada hoge, utna hi uska mole fraction zyada hoga. और जितना मोल फ्रैक्शन ज्यादा होगा उतने ही नंबर ऑफ मॉलिक्यूल क्या होगे, इवोपरेट होगे. वंस अगेन, पार्शियल प्रेशर किस पे डिपेंड करता है? मोल फ्रैक्शन पे. मोल फ्रैक्शन किस पे? नंबर ऑफ मोल्स पे. इफ आई से सपोज मान लेते हैं यहां पे अगर ए वन के 3 मोल और ए टू के 5 मोल. यस, A1 के 3 मोल, A2 के 5 मोल. तो अगर मैं A1 का अगर मोल फ्रैक्शन निकालूंगा तो क्या होगा? 3 नंबर ऑफ मोल्स अपॉन टोटल नंबर ऑफ मोल्स, दैट इज 8. अगर मैं A2 का मोल निकालूंगा, इफ आई फाइंड आउट द मोल ऑफ A2 मॉलिक्यूल, सो A2 इज इक्वल टू नंबर ऑफ मोल्स ऑफ दैट कंपोनेंट टू द टोटल नंबर ऑफ मोल्स, that is 5/8. So among these two, X2 ke mole fraction zyada hai. Jitna mole fraction zyada, utne hi number of molecules kya hoge, evaporate hoge. So I can say from here, kiska P2 ka, consider example, P2 ka partial pressure kya hoga, zyada hoga, kiska mole fraction zyada. तो यहां पे सॉल्यूशन में ऐसा नहीं है, इज नॉट जस्ट लाइक दैट कि जो सॉल्यूशन जो इवोपरेट होगा वो दोनों का वेपर प्रेशर का एडिशन होगा, ऐसा नहीं है. वो किस पे डिपेंड करेगा? पार्शियल प्रेशर पे. जिस मॉलिक्यूल का पार्शियल प्रेशर ज्यादा तो सॉल्यूशन में वो ज्यादा से ज्यादा मॉलिक्यूल क्या होगा? इवोपरेट होगा. तो राइट नाउ जस्ट फॉर योर अंडरस्टैंडिंग कि सर यहां पे A2 का मोल फ्रैक्शन ज्यादा है इसलिए इसका पार्शियल प्रेशर ज्यादा, और जितना पार्शियल प्रेशर ज्यादा होगा इसमें से A2 के मॉलिक्यूल क्या होंगे, ज्यादा से ज्यादा इवोपरेट होंगे. ऐसा नहीं इक्वली साथ में, जो ज्यादा वो ज्यादा से ज्यादा क्या होगा, इवोपरेट होगा. सो दिस इज नथिंग बट अ रॉड्स लॉ. तो वंस अगेन रॉड्स लॉ स्टेट दैट द पार्शियल वेपर प्रेशर ऑफ ईच कॉम्पोनेंट इज द प्रोडक्ट ऑफ वेपर प्रेशर ऑफ प्योर कॉम्पोनेंट एट इट्स मोल फ्रैक्शन. होप यू अंडरस्टूड द कॉन्सेप्ट दैट इज राउड्स लॉ. ओके, इन एग्जाम इट इज कम फॉर द 1 मार्क्स, सम टाइम 2 मार्क्स. ओके, स्टेट राउड्स लॉ. ओके, सो यू हैव सीन द राउड्स लॉ. सो सम डेफिनेशन लाइक अ पार्शियल प्रेशर, प्लीज हियर what is mean by partial pressure. Okay, we are listening the terms like partial pressure. So partial pressure is the pressure exerted by the individual gas in the mixture. Partial pressure is the pressure exerted by the individual gas in the mixture of different gases at same temperature. Partial pressure is the pressure exerted by the individual gas in the mixture of different gases at same temperature. Means if I consider एक room है, उस room में A1 molecular, A2 molecular, A3 molecular. Okay? So हर A1, A2 और A3, तो A1, A2, A3 three different types of gas है. तो हर गैस का क्या होगा, पार्शियल प्रेशर क्या होगा, अलग अलग होगा या सेम भी हो सकता है, लेकिन हर गैस का खुद का क्या होगा, इंडिविजुअल. सो खुद का क्या होगा, एक पार्शियल प्रेशर होगा.
चलो मान लेते हैं इसका पार्शियल प्रेशर 10 एटमॉस्फेयर है, ए टू का पार्शियल प्रेशर 15 है और ए थ्री का पार्शियल प्रेशर कितना है 5 एटमॉस्फेयर, और जितने भी जो मॉलिक्यूल होंगे गैस मॉलिक्यूल जो होगी वो क्या होगी नॉन रिएक्टिंग हो, क्या होगी नॉन रिएक्टिंग, इसको हम क्या कहते हैं आइडियल गैस भी कहते हैं। तो अगर मैं सबके पार्शियल प्रेशर को क्या करूंगा एड करूं तो आप बोलेंगे सर टोटल पार्शियल प्रेशर, तो टोटल पार्शियल प्रेशर विल बी हाउ मच, यस दैट विल बी 30 एटमॉस्फेयर, अंडरस्टूड। सो पार्शियल प्रेशर इज अ प्रेशर ऑफ इंडिविजुअल गैस इन अ मिक्सचर, इट इज अ इंडिविजुअल गैस इन अ मिक्सचर दैट इज कॉल्ड एज अ पार्शियल प्रेशर, बट व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट द टोटल पार्शियल प्रेशर सो हर मॉलिक्यूल का हर गैस का पार्शियल प्रेशर हम जब एड करेंगे तो क्या देगा आपको you will get a total partial pressure, okay? So hope you understood what is mean by partial pressure. So when we add a volatile solid in a volatile solvent, there is a formation of the solution, and the solution which is formed, it is the addition of it, which is vapor which is formed above the liquid surface, which has a partial vapor pressure of P1 as well as P2. So total partial pressure, that is according to the Dalton's law kya kehta hai, that is total partial pressure is the addition of P1 and P2. Now what is P1? So P1 is P10X1. What is P2? P20X2. Okay? Now, what is X1? We have learned the concentration terms like mole fraction, that is X1 plus X2 is equal to 1. Mole fraction of solution is equal to 1. So we can write as X1 is equal to 1 minus X2. Yes, so put the value of x1 here, so that is 1 minus x2 plus p20 x2. Now multiply, so p10 minus p10 x2 plus p20 x2, arrange it. After arranging what we get, if I put here, okay, so p20 minus P10 X2 plus P10. We will arrange this. Okay. So we finally get this equation, and this is nothing but the equation for the Raoult's law for two volatile components. Okay. Here P10 and P20 are constant. Okay. So now we see the graph of Raoult's law of solution containing two volatile components. So here I taken a, that is a y-axis, that is a vapor pressure, and x-axis is a mole fraction. Okay. So as per the Raoult's law, P1 is equal to P10. Okay, I will write here. As per the Raoult's law, P1 is equal to P10 X1 and P2 is equal to P20 X2. Okay, now so we have discussed with the Raoult's law that partial vapor pressure is directly proportional to its mole fraction. Here P1 and P2 are constant. Okay, P1 and P2 are constant. So this is the vapor pressure. Okay, and this is the mole fraction. So Raoult's law states that the partial vapor pressure of any component is directly proportional to its mole fraction. Okay, so here at this point, let us consider I have only one component, that is A1 component. मेरे पास एक A1 component है. A1 component है means इसका mole fraction कुछ ना कुछ होगा, तो I written 1 here. And has a partial vapor pressure P1. Okay? इसके अंदर X2 molecule, X2 component नहीं है, there is no H2 component because this is completely pure. Completely pure means there is H2 will be 0. तो जो भी पार्शियल प्रेशर होगा वो किसके प्रोपोर्शनल होगा, मोल फ्रैक्शन के बराबर होगा और इक्वल होगा. सो आई कैन से दैट एज वी गो फ्रॉम हियर टू हियर, जैसे मैं यहां से यहां जाऊंगा तो मैं क्या कर रहा हूं, मोल फ्रैक्शन A1 कंपोनेंट का या X1 का कम करते जा रहा हूं. तो X1 का जब मोल फ्रैक्शन कम होते जाएगा, गो ऑन डिक्रीजिंग, तो पार्शियल वेपर प्रेशर भी क्या होते जाएगा, कम होते जाएगा. यस और नो? सो वी गेट दिस ग्राफ. तो दिस ग्राफ शोज दैट P1 इज इक्वल टू P10 X1. सेम हियर इन दिस कंडीशन आई हैविंग ओनली A2 कंपोनेंट. ओनली A2 कंपोनेंट मींस इट हैज मोल फ्रैक्शन X2 हैविंग सम मोल फ्रैक्शन दैट इज 1. There is no A1 here. No A1 means X1 will be 0. And it has partial vapor pressure P2, which is directly proportional to its mole fraction as per the Raoult's law. So as we go from here to here, R and go on decreasing the mole fraction of X2. X2 ka mole fraction kam karte ja raha. तो जब मैं कम करने जाऊंगा तो वेपर प्रेशर क्या होगा, डिक्रीज होते जाएगा बिकॉज पार्शियल वेपर प्रेशर इज डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू मोल फ्रैक्शन. तो वेपर प्रेशर गोज ऑन डिक्रीजिंग. सो वी गेट दिस टू ग्राफ हियर. तो दैट इज P2 इज इक्वल टू P20 X2. ओके, सो दिस कर्व इज the curve for the solvent and this for the solute. Okay, now we add these two points. So these two points, which is the addition of partial vapor pressure, that is P1 and P2, which is called as total vapor pressure. Yes, this is called as a total vapor pressure. We can write as P is equal to P1 plus P2. Okay, this curve shows the vapor, partial vapor pressure of solution. Okay, now we can also write as P is equal to, that is total vapor pressure, P10 X1 plus P20 X2. Yes, so this is the graph of Raoult's law for two volatile component. Okay, we have completed the Raoult's law. So in the next lecture we will discuss with the vapor pressure of solution containing two component from which one is a volatile and second is a non-volatile. Okay.